Prince George's Pride is a very, very diverse group, and I think it represents PG County very well. You know, in some of these communities, a lot of these kids have never even seen a lacrosse stick. So it's one of the things we're really proud of being able to push and move forward.
My mom got the email from University of Maryland because she's an alumni. So she asked me, one day we were coming home from school, and she asked me, hey Alexis, I got this email, and it's about playing lacrosse here for the county team. And it just seemed really interesting to try something new.
I think my biggest concern for Alexis was that I was kind of looking towards her future. And what I felt like was that when you start going to college, you need the diverse background to get accepted and get more aid and financial aid and scholarship. And what I felt like is that if she was one of a few minorities that could play lacrosse, that would be an advantage for her.
I'd say about 18 months ago, we made a big push. We got a grant from U.S. Lacrosse for some gear, which really helped because that takes some of the sting of the cost out of it to help with the both boys and girls programs.
U.S. Lacrosse, over the past 2 years, developed and last year launched our First Stick program. And really, the First Stick program, it's an evolution of a lot of our other programs that has been developed to deliver resources through a multi-year partnership to fledgling and young lacrosse programs.
One thing about the lacrosse community is they really, really want to grow the game. And I think that it'll, you know, over time, it'll become more of a diverse crowd that plays lacrosse.
I think that you know, the game will continue to become more and more diverse as we move forward. It is not going to do it on its own. It is going to take some deliberate effort from people that recognize that that's important to continue to push that forward. We recognize where it's come from. I mean, it has come from a very white East Coast, you know, Mid-Atlantic, Upper Mid-Atlantic history, and that's, we embrace that and say that's just how this game has come to be. We also recognize that it's a Native American game, ironically, and that it really came from people of color, Native, you know, folks that are indigenous to this land that started this game, and so that's a history that can be taught right along. I think that is inspiring, but yet without the history that has been there, it may not have developed into the game it is today, and we just have to really try to expose where it's come from and then where it's going and how that is linked from a Native American history to including a different kind of people and populations and communities today.